in the true spirit of competitors. It's not much of a leap. To jump into spring. Then spring right into summer salt. Tristan Woodard bounced aboard his home oval with acrobatics above and beyond the event athletics. So whether over or out, warriors continued leaving their same gravity-defying mark. The two-year sweeping league champion Eastway girls still pleased Coach Emily Steele. Especially another Ayana Hover honor when she sand-sailed a personal best across the triple pit. It might have been the horizontal flight of the day. Also flung into that achievement discussion was Jude Binion. A first-year round rocket ejector exhibiting a solo long
Okay, so
Object projects aside, the around rounds included hurdles, complete with comments.
Thank you. on.
Don't play with me like that. Get in there.
Oh,
you don't play with me, man. No, I don't play. You don't, hey, I don't play games, man. I don't play tic-tac-toe. I don't play.
No, Andy got it in his hand.
More winded winding roads. And relay rotations amid the ovations.
Thank you.
Let's go, Boo. Let's go, Anya.
Development-wise, this conference convergence included some East Wake ups and downs. But any casual observer wondering if these squads will stay the chase course, need only watch those runways and landing fields, where any UFOs, unjustified false opinions, only falter. Burying doubts deep. Because even if outsiders occasionally disrupt the Blue Crew intentions, the Warrior girls and guys will close the go for it gap. Approaching their usual quest destination. I'm Don Fuller, Eastwake Television.